Hey YouTube. So, unfortunately, over the weekend, we were witness or privileged to find out about a murder by the Ferguson Township Police. According to the police, there was a violent struggle in the driver's side of a police vehicle between Michael Brown and the police officer. According to the police officer, Michael Brown attempted to reach for his weapon. And of course, this led to the shooting, in which Michael Brown was shot and killed by that police officer. Now, this event is allegedly occurred because of the police that say that it happened. However, eyewitness accounts differ from that account. They say that Michael Brown was not at the police cruiser. According to them, him and his friend were walking down the street. And as a result, the police officer in his patrol vehicle approached them, told them to get on the sidewalk. Of course, they kept walking on the street, knowing that their house is basically just a few houses away. Of course, this did not sit well with the officer. He gets out of his vehicle, draws his weapon, and begins shooting. Of course, Michael Brown puts his hands up. He gets shot in the back and turns around. And from what people say, eyewitnesses say he tried to reach for his cell phone. That was a fatal mistake because that officer shot Michael Brown eight more times or so. Michael Brown died at the scene. Troubling, or I should say even worse, is that his body just lay there on the street, bleeding. He lay there dead, and that was for about 4 or 5 hours. The community in which this occurred became outraged and angered by it, and they began to protest, and shots were fired by unknown assailants and individuals, and people began to protest. And what's disturbing is that as a result of the protests that occurred in Ferguson, Missouri, rioters and looters took to the streets to destroy establishments, to loot, to pillage. And my question is this: what did Quick Stop, what did the hair salon or the beauty supply store or the wireless device store had to do with the death of Michael Brown? Now those establishments have to file a claim and basically clean up after the mess left by the looters and rioters. Over the weekend, as a result of Michael Brown's death, there were more protests. As night approached, we had rioters doing the same thing again as the night before. And my question to the rioters or those instigating this is this: how is this going to help get justice for Michael Brown? How is this going to even help even in the investigation at all? And why is it that the rioters and looters are picking on establishments that are not able to defend themselves? If the rioters and the looters are really this angry and want justice, then why aren't they going down to the police station and ransacking the police station? Why are they not basically going to the police station and voicing their outrage there? Again, I'm not saying to the protesters, I'm saying to the rioters and looters. But apparently, I guess, some people are less equal than others. And they're taking advantage of that fact that some establishments are not armed and do not have the means to defend their property. This rioting, or I should say, this looting and pillaging does the case of Michael Brown more harm than good? And what message does this send to the rest of the Republic and to the rest of the world about Black Americans? What they're doing, the rioters and the looters, they're reinforcing that negative stereotype that we hear so often from the police and from the mainstream media. And one thing I have to say is, if Malcolm X or Martin Luther King were alive today, they would be shaking their heads in shame at the behavior of this vocal and small minority destroying their own communities. I'm going to put in the description the whole situation from the murder itself to the looting and to the shots being fired at the scene. And you can judge for yourself. Don't, please do not take my word for it. You know, any critical thinking individual would see this for what it really is, and that it's opportunists. That's what it really is. You have one side wanting justice for Michael Brown, rightfully so. Then you have another side to it that basically they just want to take advantage of the situation. And those are the ones that do any kind of justice for Michael Brown more harm than good. I don't know what to make of it, but hopefully, God willing, common sense prevails in the end. Peace.